everyone, it's Nina. Thanks so much for joining me today for a new tutorial. And I'm excited to be part of the Studio Cadia second birthday blog hop. And we're celebrating 2 years for Studio Cadia's amazing company. So for my card today, for the blog hop, I'm going to be using the Kobe Bearing Gifts stamp set and the coordinating dies. I'm going to begin by stamping this bear with the gifts onto some Simon's Stamp Ultra Heavy White cardstock, and I'm going to color this with Copic markers. I chose a variety of different colors, all coordinating as best as I could with the colors that are in the Satin Confetti sequin mix from Studio Cadia. I chose that particular sequin mix because I loved the bright and happy colors, and I wanted these Copic markers to match the colors that are in the sequins. So a lot of the colors that you're seeing me use here are coordinating with that. And I just picked different colors out of my stash to create these color combinations. Now, when I did the shading on these presents, I didn't get too crazy with the shading because there's very tiny detailed areas within these stamped images. So I'm going as much as 2 Copic colors to shade a certain area. I didn't go any more than 2 colors, just to keep the coloring simple and not have to worry about bleeding outside the lines and getting too saturated with color. I also colored in the balloon using a couple of pink markers. I really loved these pink colors. I also added a little bit of a highlight with an R10. And for the bear itself, I chose just some neutral browns. I really love the E30 family, so I used those to color in the bear. I also added a little bit of a warm R01 color to his belly to give him a little bit of a pinkish tone. And then once the coloring of the bear and the balloons and the presents were all done, I did cut all of these images out with the coordinating dies. Now, speaking of dies, there's this really cute scallop window die set from Studio Cadia, and it's brand new. And I'm going to use that to create this little scallop panel and also the cute window that can open up and create a peekaboo window that you can see into another area of the card. I'm going to be using this to create a hidden sentiment. There's a scored line that is created when you die cut this in your machine, and I'm just going to go ahead and fold that over so that way I have a nice crisp line ready to go so I can start using this then once I've decorated it. Now, speaking of decorating, I pulled out the Lawn Fawn Push Here stamp set, which features a lot of interactive greetings, and I wanted to be able to put a greeting that says open with an arrow onto the front of this window. Then I'll take one of the presents that I colored, the single present, and pop that up off of the front of the window using some foam tape. On the back side of the window, I'm going to attach some foam tape. I've cut it down into a narrow strip, and I'm going to take the adhesive backing off so that I can easily maneuver this around the curve of the window. This is going to go in towards the bottom center portion of the card, and I just need to make sure I have enough room for the sentiment underneath and for the bear that's going to be on the inside with the balloon. I'll stamp that sentiment that I had underneath of that window onto some slate gray cardstock and emboss it with white embossing powder. Once I've heat set that, I fussy cut the sentiment out using my fine tip scissors. I attached that underneath of that window using some foam tape, and I'm attaching now the balloon and Kobe onto my card using some foam tape. And I used 2 layers for the bear just to give him a little bit of extra pop and dimension. My idea for this card was to have the interactive window open up to see the bear on the inside. So when it's closed, you'll see just the presents peeking out. And when you open it up, you have the surprise of the bear bearing the gifts and giving them to the recipient for their birthday. I used a gel pen to add some expression marks to the word open and a highlight to the balloon. To embellish the balloon even further, I put a layer of glossy accents over top of the balloon and then brought in this really pretty Studio Cadia glitter to add some sparkle and shine. I just picked up a pinch and sprinkled it over top of the balloon. Once the glossy accents dries, that will embed those little glitter pieces inside of the adhesive. The satin confetti sequins that I mentioned earlier, these are what you're seeing me use right now to attach onto the background of my card. My idea was to have these sequins serve as confetti. I really love these sequins because they're so bright and colorful and happy. So I wanted to make sure I used quite a few of them in all sorts of different colors to create a very colorful background. I did ground my sentiment a little bit to create some grounding elements for the bottom portion of the card using a couple of warm gray markers. I used warm gray 3, 1, and 0, 0. The background I felt needed a bit more confetti and more color, so I brought in those same Copic markers that I used to color in the presents, and I'm just dotting different colors of those markers in and around the bigger confetti pieces. So this looks like confetti that's in the background. And of course, I couldn't stop there. I needed to embellish this further with some of those pretty clear stars from Studio Caria. Now, I also wanted to use this really cool bubble stencil from Studio Caria. It's also brand new. So I'm taking this bright white envelope and I've masked off an area to serve as the addressing portion of the envelope. And I'm going to tape that stencil down so I can stencil on some Simon Says Stamp colors of ink. I picked out colors that would match with the card, and I'm going to start sponging on a rainbow of colors to the background of this envelope. The colors I used were Audrey Blue, Jelly Bean, Lemon Zing, Clementine, Teeny Bikini, and Hot Mama. I love all of these colors. These are some of my most favorites of the Simon inks. And I'm using Tsukaneko little mini daubers that can go ahead and get into those nice small areas of the stencil very easily and quickly. I really love the sponge daubers for little techniques like this. So once the stenciling was done, I took the stencil off and I'm going to remove the mask. And you can see we have this nice bright white area now that where we can add the recipient's address to the front side of the envelope. I also used a black pen and added a little frame around the negative area and that post-it note I'm using to make some straight lines for the address. Now this is going to finish off the card. You can see that we have our cute little envelope, and I didn't catch it on camera, but I do have my greeting that I had put on the inside in there as well. That's going to finish off this card. I love all the bright and happy colors, and I hope you do too. I love that the Studio Caria new release features so many fun products that can be used so well together. I hope you'll stop by my blog to see still pictures of this card and also learn more details about the Studio Caria birthday blog hop. There's lots of giveaways, so make sure you click on the link to my blog right here on screen or in the video description below. And I'll see you again very soon with another tutorial. Until then, have a great day and thanks for watching.